All right, we're back. Thanks very much. So in our last segment, we actually saw how to add some navigation to the app so that we could focus on specific colleagues that we're working with. We also learned how to pull, how to filter the events that we're showing, how to pull emails in and how to filter those. And then we saw how to use the File Insights API to get insights into what people are working on. So Rabia, you said something earlier in the section where you were talking with Waldeck. You made a really good point that we are geographically distributed. I mean, we're all over the world in our team. And I think this is happening more and more these days. I'm wondering if there's some way we could show the locations of the users inside of our app and also really show time zones, because time zones are really the tricky part, right? Like even right now, the three of us are on three different continents and it's quite late where you are.
That's right. So we all know that because we are in our team. We are all globally distributed and we probably know our teammates' sleeping patterns more than probably our parents or family. So I guess that's an important functionality that we should add in the app to know more about our team. So let's jump in to our Get My Colleagues function, which we saw earlier in our session with Waldeck. And we basically pulled out all the colleagues information. We saw their discipline names, job title, department. And what you also noticed is we are picking up city, state, and country of our of our colleagues as well.
Wow. So that's in the graph too, so I can get all that information. I don't have to pop up and say, hey, where are you or anything.
Nope. It's all there. Wow. And the developer does not even have to know where this information is coming from, which service from M365 is providing. All they need to know is how to work with graph. So this information is great. As you can tell, with this information, I can go ahead and call Bing API or any other API that will give me a time zone. For here, we have a function called get time zone information. And all what we are doing here is passing the location information of the users. So if you're going to peek into this function, you can see here exactly what we're doing. We are using the Bing REST API and passing all that information as a query. And we're also passing the Bing Maps API key, which is a configuration that you want to add into your ENV file, which is right here. So I'll open up the sample. This is how your configuration would look like. And this is where your API key is. So that's all what we have done. And we get the time zone. And this, I think it's pretty brilliant idea, and it should be there in every application possible. If you can see the time zone with your users, great. I don't have to second guess when you're going to wake up, when you're going to be replying to my pings. This is it. So let's...
You're absolutely
right. Yeah, so let's go ahead and find out in our browser.
Okay.
Awesome. So that's how it looks. You have your colleague information. At the same time, you have their time information. You have their time zone and where they are from. So I think this is an icebreaker in itself. Yes. So I know these people are in this location, in this time zone, when I'm booking a meeting next.
That's really cool. The only thing that could possibly be cooler would be if we could see all of these people as points on a map.
Well, you guessed it right. It's because we have it.
There it is.
So
amazing. Okay, there we are. Wow, this is great.
Because anyway, we're using the Bing API, we might as well just indulge with more map functionality, but all thanks to Graph for giving me the location information. So we've got all the pins here. This exactly looked like how our colleagues are distributed. We've got Australia, we've got Europe, we've got America. And the good thing is you could even see where they are based on each user. As you saw earlier, you could select and see information per colleague. You could also see where they are in the map.
Oh, nice. It looks like you're also pulling in some other information about the user. That's really nice.
Yeah, so this section that you see here is the about me of your colleague. So it's a good way to get to know what they work on, what their hobbies are maybe, you know, the kind of projects they're passionate about. All this information is right here as well, again, coming from Graph. So let's go back and see how that works in the code. So here in the information that we are pulling out for our colleagues, you might have noticed we don't have about me. Not every endpoint has all the information like we discussed before. They're all distributed in Graph. So we have something called the profile information that we are getting here. The profile information would give you the about me. So that is basically just about the user. There, again, some information are duplicated here, but not all. So what you saw in the Direct Reports API, we have much more information that you can show from a user that is this about me information. Mm-hmm. That is being pulled out and being displayed under each of these colleagues, which you are seeing here.
Wow, that's really cool. This is starting to look really good. Like, we could actually use this thing. So I think, you know, this is really kind of cool how this whole thing has kind of built up right here in this single page app. So is that it? Like, the Graph is good for single page apps, right? Is there other scenarios where it could be useful? What if I wanted to write, I think there are other SDKs, right? Like, anything that could call a REST call could call the Graph, but what if I'm writing like an Android app or an iOS app or universal Windows app or even a bot? Like, would the Graph work from those places as well?
Absolutely. And for that reason, let's go to a bot. So we had a hack week previously, a couple of weeks back, and we built a bot, which basically is very similar to this SP application. It's around you as a person, but here you can see it's more about your colleagues as well. But what if you want to create like a personal assistant bot? So anytime I think about a bot functionality, it's mostly to assist a user to do something. So in our case, let's see a bot working who is going to get me the same information, but around me, around my my events or my files. Again, the similar kind of an application, but as a bot. So what I'm going to do now is jump to a bot composer. So we've built a this personal assistant bot using the bot framework composer, and it connects to Graph and gets information from Graph. And I'll show you how it works in a minute, but let me explain to you a few things that you probably are curious on how to call Graph in a bot composer. So away from the JavaScript application, how would you do it in a different scene? So here we have something called a dialogue. So in bot composers, you can have actions, you can get information, you can give response back to the user, etc. Here we are using a few things like auth. That's the most important bit. You need to connect to Graph.
Yeah, so just like we were, Waldeck showed earlier, actually authenticating to the single page app in JavaScript. Is this the same thing in the bot?
That's the same thing. All you're doing is logging in, getting the token. So token is what you need to make another API request for Graph. And this action in the bot composer would do exactly that. All you need is a connection. And once you have a connection in Graph set up, we've already set this up in the bot composer, and we are just using the connection here. And once that is done, the user will get the same button that you saw in the JavaScript application. Then you go ahead and sign in. And once signed in, once this connection is successful, you get the token. And once you have the token, you just need to make the same call that you saw earlier in the files session. You saw the trending files, right? So it's using the insights workload. And with the same call and with the authorization token, we are going to make another call to Graph. So it's basically all around you knowing how to make Graph calls. And you can build any kind of application that can go ahead and talk to Graph and get the information from Microsoft 365. So let's see how this works in action. What I'm gonna do now is start the bot. And I already have another tool as well for demo purposes. It's called a bot emulator, basically like a simulator for bots. So I don't have to host it anywhere. I can just open up and see how it works. So that's what I'm starting here. I'm going to start the bot and I'm going to show you the emulator where this works. So we got the a bot running now. Let's go ahead and test it in the emulator. So I'm opening up the tool that I just talked to you about before. Click on that. Okay, so this is the emulator. And it's starting the conversation. Right, so it's connecting to the bot now, which is running in this local host. All right, so here it is, our personal assistant bot. It says, howdy, what can I do for you? So what I wanna see is what's up, what's trending, what's happening. So I'm just gonna click here, which basically goes off and kick off that authentication dialogue that we saw earlier, which will go ahead and give me the sign-in button. So it's very similar to the SPA application that we saw earlier. I'm gonna go ahead and sign in. And this will do all the auth and give the token back to the bot. And with that bot, we'll go ahead and process the graph call that we saw earlier for getting the files, the trending files. So you can see here the trace of all the network that's happening here, the calls being made to graph, what's being retrieved. All this information is in the trace of the emulator. And that's probably the reason why we chose this to show you that they're the same calls that you saw earlier. For example, if I open this trace, you can see here the graph call for trending, and that's exactly what you're seeing here. Insights and trending, so it's the same graph call that we made earlier. So we have all the trending files shown by the bot. Now, if you go back to the application, you can see here that the trending files that you saw in the SPA application is the same list that's being given to you. It's the same call. But in a different setup, in a bot that we created using the bot composer.
That's really cool. I love it. And so I could be asking this bot on from my phone or something. Maybe I didn't want to run the whole app and everything. A quick question about this. I noticed that the login button is in both the single page app and the bot. And it makes sense while we're testing here that you're logging in maybe with different users. If we actually built a production app, say it was running in Microsoft Teams, which is where people are collaborating a lot, would it be necessary to have that login button every time they use the app?
Yeah, for this bot, it would mean that if it's the same user who's signing in after they've already signed in successfully, it would be there for a time period, maybe 6 months. So if this this bot is in the Teams application, if you're uploaded into Teams, then it would mean that it's the same. So it's for that period of time, you don't have to re-sign in if you're the same user who signed in successfully. Now for tabs in Teams, there is SSO available at the moment just for tabs, which is pretty awesome. And it's in developer preview at the moment, but yeah. It's there. These options are there for you to make it easier for the users to not keep on logging into your application.
All right. Well, thanks, Rabia. This has been really, really interesting. I love how you combined another cloud service in with the Microsoft Graph. And presumably, I think a lot of developers, of course, their app is going to do more things than just show information from the graph, but they can combine, just like you combined the Bing information with the graph information, they can combine their own apps in with the graph and just provide the information that users need to see rather than asking them to navigate to different places to pull together the information they need.
Yes, it is. My favorite part is the time zone. I'm still hung up on that.
Thanks, Rabia, and thanks everyone for joining. And I'll turn it back over to the main program already in progress. Mm-hmm.